Hi, my name is Swamzi, and this is my Studio Z. In this video, we are going to discuss about something which I've done previously, like how to download 3D models and download it to Maya. It's a previous video, but it's getting views right now. Like, I've done it 1 year ago, and now it's getting views, and some people are asking me in the comments, like, some questions. So I thought, why not make a video on that? If you didn't watch my previous video, I'll give the link here so you can go there and watch it. And let's get into the topic. The first question everybody is asking is that which format to be downloaded? If you are using a particular software, then it supports some formats. Like, I'll tell you in the video, like, which format to be downloaded if you're using software like Panda Maya or some other software. And the second question is how to separate objects. Like, it's not regarding this topic, but I'll explain to you how to separate objects as well in this video. And the third question is, it's an important question, like, is it legal to download from the websites that I've given? I'll give all the links in the description so you can go there and check it. I'll give the link to the previous video in the description as well so you can go there and check it. And the number one question, which format to be downloaded? So if you want to download the models and you don't know which format to be downloaded, then this is one of the websites that I've given in the previous video. Like, it's a CG Trader. If you come here at the top, you get the formats here. Like, just click on that and you can see what format to be downloaded. FBX and OBJ, these two formats works for every software that I literally used. Maya, Blender, iClone, whatever. OBJ and FBX work for all the softwares, and there are more models available on the market for free in these formats like FBX and OBJ. And if you scroll down, it has a 3ds Max file, dot max, and dot blend file, which is for Blender, and C4D file for Cinema 4D, and MA and MB for Maya. Maximum, these are the softwares you use, but GDLF, GLB, this works for Blender and Rhinoceros 3D, 3DM, and the 3D Studio. And let me just this Scalera.dae file works for Blender as well. If you are a 3D artist, just download Blender and keep it aside. You can just use it at least for import and export purposes. SketchUp file, SKP, and there's iClone file as well here. Let me show you that. Yeah, here we have Unreal Engine as well, Unreal Asset, UE Asset, iClone, iProp, IACC, and iClone, DASTudio.duf, something like that. These are the formats you can download in the website. But the model comes with different formats. Like, it is done in Max, but it comes in FBX and matte and more. Some, if you click on this, then it will show you that which format it is. So for the second question, I'm going to be downloading this model, like this car here. And I'm using Blender to separate the objects. The second question, if you download the model, it comes like this. If you don't know how to download the models, I'll give the link to that in the description so you can go there and watch it. Let's just click on it and extract here. I got extracted. It will be shown like this. You can see the logo of Blender here because it's a blend file. So let's just open Blender. And if you want to see what formats you can import it to Blender, go to import section and you can see there are formats here. These are all the things you can import into Blender. So let me just open it because it's a blend file. You can directly open it. It's a native format to Blender. Now this is the car. Let me just click on back to previous so you can go to. This is it. If you want to see the materials as well, so you click on this, it will show you the materials. Work in this view because my CPU can't handle it, because I'm recording right now and doing it at the same time. If you're not doing recording, it works perfectly fine. Click on this and hit material. This is not the original color. It looks like black. You can see the metal here. Right? This is how it looks, the car, this red thing over here. See? So these two doors are combined, so I want to separate this thing. Like, let me just drag it out, and I want to separate this. Hit tab on your keyboard so you can go into edit mode and click on this little icon, which is X-ray, by the way, so that we can select all the things. I'm in vertex mode, so I'm selecting all the things on both sides because it's an extra mode, so it will select both sides. I click on the object and go to separate tab and click on by loose parts. Now it is separated. You can see a little bit of gap in it because this was modeled separately and then after it was combined. So if you hit loose parts, it will be separated. But this object is done in a single object. You can't separate this by loose parts. The only thing you can do is you have two options. One, do it manually, or check it has any different materials or any different textures you want to separate. Let's just say, let me just create a material so you can understand what I'm saying. I'm giving it a green material. And I'm just going to face mode. So you can see this is a different material applied to this object. Let me just show you in a material view. See this green color? This is what it looks like in material. It is not showing up in the object view. But let's say material separate. There is a material which is separating the object. So if you want to separate that material, now go to edit mode and select all the things. Send process. Hit this and select all the things. You can do this in vertex mode, edge mode, and face mode. All the things will be fine. But you have to select all the things, all the vertices, edges, or faces. Right click on the object, go to separate. Now by material. If you hit by material, this happens. Because material is separating the object, like literally we can see, right? This is green and this is not right now. Now this is green and this is black, right? You can separate that by material. If you don't have any textures and materials on it, the only thing you can do is separate it manually. Click on it, hit tab, and select all the faces. Let's just say I've done a wonderful selection. I've done a wonderful selection. And I want to separate this. I click on it, separate, and now by selection. These are the only things that are available in Blender. This type of things also are available on other 3D applications like Maya, 3ds Max, whatever. Every application has this kind of thing. Only thing you have to do is find where it is. There are so many tutorials out there which will show you how to do it. And third question, is it legal to download from the websites that I've given? Yeah, it's completely legal for you to download because it's a free website and it has some paid models as well. And some artists are giving the content for free so you can download it and use it. But at least give them a little bit of credit. Don't say you done the project and you done the model. Just give some credit to the creator. They are doing something for recognition, so you can just give him a little bit of credit so he'll feel happy. And that's it for this video, guys. If you don't already click the subscribe button, click down below and subscribe to it. And thank you for watching. See you guys next time.